very primitive man. Or you, and what? Who is the little guy?
I was working in a farmer with a Muslim family. We two were living there. He invited me that you all family should embrace Islam and come to Islam. When we totally refused and we will not come under their pressure, then they abused my daughter. I was working in a farm. He came to my home and he saw my young daughter and kidnapped her. When I went back to my home, so I saw my daughter was not there. Then on one field I saw him that he was raping her, and when he saw me, he left her unconscious with bleeding and ran away. I wanted to catch him, but when I saw my daughter unconscious and full of bleeding, I was not able to even go any further, so I took her in my hands. She has a nightmare and she's still traumatized. And there are some depression, but there are many other things which I cannot show on her body. She cannot pass urine in a normal way, so they made another hole from here for to pass urine and, you know, the other thing. On every knock on our door, we think that someone came to kill us. Yes, I went to the police, but due to their pressure, the police was not listening to us. Till now, they are threatening us. They are after our lives and they wanted to kill us.
Very tough to meet this little girl. It's one of the most hard things that I ever did in my life. This little girl will not be able ever to be married, to get married. She will never be able to live a normal life. Not only that, she is a threat to the rest of her life and she needs to be in hiding, she and her family, just because in case that the Muslim extremists know where they are, they can arrest them again, they can rape them again, and they can torture them again. And we need to do something about that.
Nia Munir is 2.5 years. Her father was a farmer, a Christian. He's a Christian farmer. The owner of the farm went to him, told him, I want you to convert to Islam. He told him, no. The son of the owner of the farm, he's 18 years old. He went, he attacked the girl two years, he kidnapped her two and a half years old, and he raped her.
There's two important topics I want to speak with you. Neha is 2 years old, who was raped by an 18 years old Muslim man. Yes, now she's four, this was 2 years ago. And Neha, family right now hiding underground in Pakistan. And I need to get her here to Canada. Anyway, okay, so I just need to do it.
Thinking about Nia for the last 3 years. Thinking if we fail. Thinking if we succeed. So, all of this is good. Just a heavy burden. It's a very heavy burden.
Let's go now to the Canadian embassy, please. I worked 3 years for this small little passport. 3 years, hard work. And we got it.
Around 9:15 now in the evening in Islamabad.
and as we're getting closer, the danger is also increasing. And countdown, and just tomorrow morning the operation is supposed to take place. But everything will be okay.
Tomorrow in the morning, we are going to the airport. And we are taking you to Canada. And this will be the land of your freedom, and this will be the future for you and your family. Let's go.
This is very exciting. Pam is just about to come out from the immigration. So we're expecting them any second now. This will be really good. I hear the kids are all pumped up and excited and had a great time on the airplane, all that kind of stuff. So it should be very, very good.
But after 3 years, this era is over. And make it a lesson. Everyone will try to hurt the child. Anybody will try to hurt the minority in Pakistan. We will help these people and we will get them out. Make no mistake. And always remember that light always prevails over the darkness.
Mission accomplished. It's over. It's over.